Can it also be related to, am I so incomplete that I need to be, you know, reminded constantly of completeness?
Yes. But when you have started believing in incompleteness, what is the option? What is the option? Being drunk may not be your nature. Is it one's nature to be drunk and act like a fool? But what if you have taken alcohol from the world and are drunk now? What is the option? What else can be done? The key may be in your own pocket. But if you have forgotten it, it's remember. It's your own key and it's in your own pocket, so close to you. But what if you have forgotten? You need to be quickly, quick, quick, quick. You need to be. You don't need to be given the key, but you need to be
reminded
that you need not be a beggar. You already have it. Just reminder, just reminder. And you may have the most palatial of houses and the best of cars, but they are useless if you forget the, and the keys in your own, which pocket? Not this one here, the pocket close to your heart. That's why love, love is the key, close to the heart. You need to be reminded. See, observe this instance. When the world constantly tells you that you are inferior, do you ever question the world? But did you catch yourself asking me right now that why are you reminding me that I am not inferior? The world is all the time reminding you that you are inferior and you never question the world. An advertisement comes and says that unless you buy this car, your life is worthless. Do you ever sue the advertiser? Rather, you go and buy that car. You are so alright with your own sense of inferiority that you would never question somebody when he is calling you inferior. But when there is a reminding process going on, you kind of feel a little awkward.
But I think that is something that is hidden, for when it comes point blank as a direct reference, then
we feel bad.
We try and, you know,
resist, yes. Even this resistance shows that inferiority is not our nature, right? Had inferiority been our nature, then you would have just accepted, all right, yes sir, I'm inferior. Thank you so much.
It's too good to be true.
See, this is such a beautiful observation. How can our language have this kind of an attitude? Too good to be true. We never say too bad to be true. We never say too bad to be true. But if it's sounding good, something fishy.
Some catch.
How can joy be my nature? Frustration must be my nature.